Greetings everyone. Today we'll discuss about polymerase chain reaction, or in short it is called PCR. Polymerase chain reaction is a process by which one piece of DNA is used for making multiple copies of itself. So polymerase chain reaction, what we do? We make multiple copies of DNA from a single DNA. So in this process, an instrument is used that is called PCR chamber. It is nothing but a container or test tube like thing in which temperature can be regulated. Temperature can be increased quickly and temperature can be decreased quickly. So in this process, what is done? The PCR, the entire process consists of three steps. First step, we call it denaturation. First step is called denaturation. Here, solution containing piece of DNA is heated to 94 degree Celsius. 94 degree Celsius. So now, when we heat it, what happens? Now it is denatured. The hydrogen bonding between the nitrogen become weak and they separate to form two single stranded DNA. So this process is called denaturation. This is the original piece of DNA. So we are indicating by giving a cross here. This is our original piece of DNA. Then second step, we call it renaturation or annealing. Or annealing. In this process, what happens? Reaction mixture is cooled down to temperature of 50 to 60 degrees, say 55 degrees Celsius. The temperature between 50 to 60. So when temperature decreases, these strands tend to unite again to form a double-stranded DNA. However, in mixture, in the reaction mixture, some small piece of DNA, single-stranded DNA called primer, oligonucleotide primer is there, which is complementary to the part of the DNA. So what happens? This primer small piece of DNA, they come and join instead of uniting the original DNA. What happens? The small piece of DNA, which are called primers. So these are small strands of oligonucleotides. Nucleotides having 17 to 30 bases. Okay. So their number is more and their size is more. So during renaturation, instead of original strand, these small pieces come quickly and attaches itself to the original strand of DNA. So So this process is called renaturation or annealing. So a piece is inserted in between so that they cannot unite. Third step, we call it synthesis. Synthesis. In this process, what is happen? What happens? The temperature is raised to 74 degree Celsius. So this is the strands 5-3. So this small one, this is 3-5-3. Now, when temperature is raised to 74 degree Celsius, an enzyme is there which is thermostable. The name of the enzyme is TAC DNA polymerase. This enzyme, polymerase the enzyme, it has specialty. If they find any broken piece of DNA, they can complete the strand. So this enzyme join here and complete the strand. This is the original strand. Complete the strand. This is the synthesis. This process, it takes around 1 minute. This one, this process also take around 1 minute, and this is around 2.5 minute. Total 5 minute in a cycle. So now you see, we have two pieces of double stranded DNA. Okay, so now this each DNA, if you see, have one original strand and complementary original strand. Here this is the original strand and this is the newly synthesized complementary strand, which is same as this one. Second one, you see, this is the complementary original strand, and here complementary to the complementary original strand is synthesized. That is, this strand is like the original strand. So these two DNA are nothing but the copy of this DNA. So this is the first cycle of Fischer. If you repeat this process, that is, again temperature is raised to 94 degrees Celsius. So now again this will be separated, again primer will join, again new strands will be formed. So from one we are having two. Now from in the second cycle, what will happen? From two strands we will have four strands of DNA. So this is the cycle. If we see the reaction, what happens? This is the temperature. This is around 90 degrees Celsius. So what will happen when 90 degrees Celsius temperature is raised to 90 degrees Celsius? Then kept for 1 minute. Then it will come back to around 50 degrees Celsius. Kept for 1 minute. Then it is raised to 74 degrees Celsius. Kept for 2.5 minutes. So total, you see, total around 5 minutes. Again next cycle will begin like this, cyclic procedure. Here you see some materials are used. As I already discussed about the primers. Primers are small pieces of DNA, okay, which is complementary to the portion of the DNA. Okay, so this is the length is how much length? 17 to 30 bases, small piece of DNA. So that is the primer. The reaction mixture will contain numerous primers in excess quantity, so that they can compete during annealing process. Second thing material we are using, TAC DNA polymerase. This is a DNA polymerase. What is its function? If it gets some incomplete DNA strand, it will complete the strand. So now TAC means it is obtained from a microorganism called Thermus aquaticus. Thermus aquaticus. This is a kind of microorganism obtained near the hot spring. Obtained near the hot spring, the temperature is very high. So this microorganism, speciality of this enzyme, it can withstand. It is not, as you know, enzymes are protein in nature. They are denatured or destroyed in higher temperature. However, this enzyme, which is obtained from Thermus aquaticus, is resistant to temperature, at least up to 100 degrees Celsius. It is not destroyed. So when we raise the temperature to 95 degree, it is not destroyed. Okay. So this is the second enzyme. And third thing we add numerous deoxyribonucleotides of each nitrogenous base. Deoxyribonucleotides. Okay, so it is indicated as how? CTP. These are the deoxyribonucleotides. These are added. These are actually joined here to complete the formation as per the, which is the original nucleotide base. This PCR has numerous application. So I will briefly discuss or mention some of these application. First application, as I told you, it is used for multiplication of DNA, that is for making copies of DNA, for making copies of DNA. Okay, so it is used for making somewhat modified PCR, making DNA in protein engineering. It is used for diagnosis of diseases. Like what? A child is in its mother's womb. From little amount of its amniotic fluid, we can determine the probable genetic diseases of the child. First thing, that is the determination of genetic disorder, disease related to genetic disorder, the PCR is useful because very little sample is available. Second thing, for identification of retrovirus. Retrovirus, they contain very little quantity of DNA. So for identification of that, it must be amplified first. And it is also useful for the identification of some of the rare bacteria. newer form of bacteria. It can be used for the identification of diseases like cancer. Nowadays, corona infection is going on, which is caused by COVID-19 virus, coronavirus 19. This is a RNA virus, that is DNA is not there, RNA virus. So that is also identified by PCR technique, but modified, that is called RT-PCR. RT-PCR. So what is done? With an additional enzyme called reverse transcriptase. Reverse transcriptase. So virus is taken, its RNA is converted to DNA, then DNA is multiplied by PCR. So RT-PCR. So this RNA virus can also be identified by modified PCR technique, that is the RT-PCR. So PCR technique is used for gene sequencing. Genetic mapping. Another application of PCR is in forensic science. So you see, for the identification of criminal, one piece of hair or a tinge of blood or some few cells from the fingerprint, from the spit, so very little amount of genetic sample may be obtained, so which is not sufficient for analysis, but from that too we can make multiple copies of DNA and the criminal can be identified, and that is in the forensic side PCR has application. So this is polymerase chain reaction and its application. Thank you.